Works or looks like an ordinary dividing head for indirect or simple dividing. That means the crank D is connected via shaft with the worm A, and the worm A drives the worm wheel B. So far so good, but now the spindle is let out of the housing and connected to a set of change gears G. The change gears are connected with a set of bevel gears F, and the bevel gears drive a set of spur gears E, which is connected to the dividing plate C. That means if you turn the crank D, then the plate will rotate also either in the same direction as the crank or in the other direction. It depends. The sketch here is taken from my book Fräsen für Hobby-Schlosser und Oldtimer-Fans, which would read in English Milling for Amateur, Craftsmen and Vintage Fans. Got the whole idea from an article in the English magazine Model Engineers Workshop, especially the issue of December 2018. Here, Mr. John Olsen of New Zealand described his own homemade differential dividing head. And you see here how it's working. The spindle is led out of the housing here. Here are the change gears, the bevel gears, and the spur gears connected to the dividing plate. I got in contact with Mr. Olsen and he allowed me to print these pictures in my book, and so everything is legally correct and in order. Basically similar is a spiral milling attachment. Here you see my own home-built spiral milling attachment for cutting helical gears. The plate is connected to spur gears. Spur gears are connected to bevel gears. They are hiding behind here. And the change gears are not connected with the spindle, but with the spindle of the x-axis, moving the whole attachment in this direction. If you are interested in such a spiral milling attachment, then please consult our video number 157. Here you see my own differential dividing head. Here an ordinary dividing head. And here the spindle is led out by a kind of adapter, which you will see in the video. Here comes the first stage of spur gears I1, 60 teeth and 60 teeth. This is only here to make room for the change gears on this side. And here you see the first stage of change gears, this and this. I called it I1 first stage, and here's the second stage of the change gears, I2, this one and this one, which is connected to the bevel gears, I3, which are connected to the second set of spur gears, I4, 60 teeth and 60 teeth, which is connected to the division plate. Okay, now some calculations. Let's choose 14 divisions. That means 90 divided by 14 is 6.4286. I is the ratio of the dividing head, which is here 90. This is where the 90 comes from. And now we choose an auxiliary division number 15. The pitch circle of holes 15 exists on one of the three division plates. and 90 divided by 15 is exactly 6. The difference D makes 6.42 minus exactly 6 makes 0.4286 crank revolutions in addition. For 6.4286 crank revolutions, these are 6.4286 divided by 90, and this makes 0.07143 spindle revolutions. 0.07143 times IW makes 0.4286, thus IW is 0.4286 divided by 0.07143, and this makes exactly 6. The difference D is 90 divided by 14 minus 90 divided by 15, and now with some calculations you come to the result of IW is 90 divided by 14, left parenthesis 15 minus 14, right parenthesis, or in general IW is I, that means the ratio of the dividing head, divided by S, times left parenthesis S minus T, right parenthesis, or here in our case 90 divided by S times left parenthesis S minus T, right parenthesis. With T is the number of divisions which we will want to make in reality, and S is an auxiliary division number close to T, maybe above or below, and an existing pitch circle of holes from the given division plates. 15 exists, 14 not. And another result, crank revolutions NK makes I divided by S, and which is here in our case 90 divided by S. Let us have a look on the change gears. We have the first stage which is connected with a spindle Z1, and the next gear Z2. Black makes the first stage of the change gears, and green Z3 combined with Z4, and Z4 goes to the division plate. NK is I divided by S, which is here 90 divided by S, and IW is I divided by S, left parenthesis S minus T, right parenthesis, which is here 90 divided by S, left parenthesis S minus T, right parenthesis, and which is Z1 divided by Z2 times Z3 divided by Z4. This is the ratio of our change gears. And as you know, T is the number of divisions we want to make, and S is the auxiliary number of divisions, which is close to T. You may choose as you want. Our first example reads as follows. Number of divisions we want to make is 14. And we will choose an auxiliary number of divisions as 15. That means NK is 90 divided by 15 is exactly 6. IW is 90 divided by s, left parenthesis s minus t, right parenthesis, is 90 divided by 15, 15 minus 14, and this is the complete ratio of the change gears Z1 divided by Z2 times Z3 divided by Z4. And this is 90 divided by 15 times 1, because 15 minus 14 is 1. A gear of 15 teeth, we have here a module of 1.25, which is roughly in imperial pitches DP20. Such a gear is very small. Thus, we make the following: 90 divided by 30. And we make for the next stage a division 2 to 1. That means 60 divided by 30. And this is the same as 90 divided by 15 times 1. Next example, we will make 57 divisions. Now we choose an auxiliary number of divisions 55, which is smaller than 57 or below. NK is 90 divided by S, is 90 divided by 55, and this is 1 plus 35 divided by 55, and this is 1 plus 7 divided by 11, and this is 1 plus 21 divided by 33. Because this is the only pitch circle of holes we have on the division plates. We have neither 55 nor 11. That means we must make one full revolution plus 21 divisions on the 33 pitch circle of holes. IW is 90 divided by S, left parenthesis s minus t, right parenthesis, which is 90 divided by 55. 55 minus 57, and this makes the ratio of the change gears Z1 divided by Z2 times Z3 divided by Z4, and this is minus 90 divided by 55 times 2, and this means minus 90 by 55 times 60 divided by 30, for example. You could choose also 90 divided by 45 or whatever you want, what will make a 2. Here we have the situation that we have a minus here, because 55 minus 57 is minus 2. And that means we must mount an idler gear to change the direction of revolution. Okay, I think you will have got it.
Thank you. Thank you.